We are given a function g of x equals x minus 5 quantity squared, which is not 1-to-1, and asked to restrict the domain so that the resulting function is 1-to-1, and then find the associated inverse function. Well, to be 1-to-1, a function must either be strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. And so my plan would be to notice, because of the symmetry of the parabola, that breaking the domain at the vertex of the parabola will accomplish the effect that we would like to. And so notice that the two possibilities would be to restrict the domain to x less than or equal to 5, or x greater than or equal to 5. Either of these would be the largest possible domain that would still end up being 1-to-1. I think the most common way to proceed would be to use the interval from 5 to infinity, including the 5. If we use that, then notice that as a result, the x minus 5 quantity is greater than or equal to 0. Because if x is greater than or equal to 5, x minus 5 is greater than or equal to 0. So now, as we proceed to find the inverse, first of all, we'll start with g, writing its two variable equation as y equals x minus 5 squared. Since x minus 5 is greater than or equal to 0, as we take the square root of both sides here, we do not need a plus or minus, because the x minus 5 is known to be positive. So when we take the square root of the square of x minus 5, we get the absolute value of x minus 5, which in turn is x minus 5, because the quantity is positive. So we get the square root of y equals x minus 5, and therefore x equals the square root of y plus 5. And therefore, the two variable equation for g inverse of x, or g inverse, would be y equals the square root of x plus 5. Or in turn, that g inverse of x equals the square root of x plus 5. And so that graph would be the inverse of the g of x when x is greater than or equal to 5. On the other hand, if we chose the domain from negative infinity to 5, including the 5, the x minus 5 would be less than or equal to 0. Then when we went to solve for x, we'd start out with y equals x minus 5 squared, but when we take the square root of both sides, we will want the negative value on the y, on the square root of y. Remember, it would be plus or minus the square root of y. This time it's going to be plus, be minus the square root of y, because the x minus 5 is going to be a negative value. And so then we get that x equals five minus the square root of y, and g inverse would have the equation y equals five minus the square root of x. So g inverse of x would equal 5 minus the square root of x. Now, so there are two different answers for this. Almost everyone generally will choose the one on the left.